Hey everyone, good morning. Good morning, at least if you are here on the West Coast. But it's so good to see you. Good afternoon, good evening, happy Thursday, happy Friday Eve. Oh my goodness, we're so close to the weekend. Bakari HD, hello, Joseph Hazel, what's going on, guys? Wow, you guys never miss a beat. I am so impressed by your loyalty. I really am happy to have you. As always, we've got a lot going on, a good show. I would even say a great show for you today. So I hope you can catch Top 30. Last night was the country music's biggest night. Any country fans out there? You love country music? I love Trace Atkins. I know like four country songs. No, kidding. I love Carrie Underwood. I love Trace Atkins. I love Blake Shelton, mostly because of his performance on reality TV, but also some of his songs. Anyway, my point is, with Country Music Awards at the Country Music Awards in Nashville, did anybody watch? All the big names were there, and I love award season, love award shows because of the red carpet, all the awards, just all the glitz and glams of it. I just can't get enough. So there were some amazing performances from Keith Urban, Luke Bryan, Carrie Underwood, and Florida Georgia Line. And if you watched the awards, let me know. Who you think was great? Who did you love? Did you love what everyone was wearing? Everyone is talking about Keith Urban's surprising win as Entertainer of the Year. Is that surprising to you? Okay. And also people are talking about who won Best Female Vocalist, which a teary-eyed Carrie Underwood took home. Can you believe Carrie Underwood won American Idol? Can you believe she's from American Idol? I can't even get over it. And she's now this mega star. I also can't believe how beautiful her legs are. She has the best legs. I'm like, are those even real? I love her. She's pregnant with her. She and her husband are expecting another child, her husband, Mike Fisher. So she co-hosted the awards for the 11th year in a row. She also sent out a pretty inspiring message to us working mamas across the country. Did you see that? If you didn't watch the show, maybe you saw it on social media. After the show, Carrie said, sorry, I've been recovering from this cold for like 4 weeks. It's so annoying. But after the show, Carrie said, hopefully I can be an inspiration to my children and to other working moms because we got this. I love that. We got this, ladies. And it's good to have Carrie Underwood on our side as well. So now we all know. Just to keep it moving here. Oh, wait, quick timeout. Christopher Howard says, Willie Nelson, LOL. All right, you a big fan? Christopher also says, hey, how you doing today, beautiful? Well, thank you so much. I'm doing fantastically, thank you. All right, we all know some of the crazy theories about the Earth's shape, right? Well, parody Twitter accounts are dedicated to the banana Earth theory. You've heard that? Taco Earth theory and the dinosaur Earth theory. But there's one new Earth theory that may actually have some loyal followers, the donut Earth theory. Have you heard of it? Yes, it's a thing. Since 2016, people on the internet have been arguing that the Earth is not flat, it's not round, but donut shaped. Can you believe that? And the funny thing, or at least what I get a kick out of, is these are serious. Like, this is not a joke. There are legitimate, you know, people out there who think the Earth is donut shaped. Are there any other Earth conspiracy theories you think are funny? I think I'm going to stick with the round Earth theory for now, but let me know if you have any creative theories and I will read them aloud as we go along. Bakari, thank you so much. He says, get well ASAP. I'm trying to, you know, when someone in the house gets it, everyone in the house gets it. So my family is just kind of like, You're it. All right, let's keep it moving, you guys, and move on to the next topic. How's Thanksgiving prep going? Let me know. Do you have your list and all that going? Have you gone shopping yet? Do you wait till the last minute like me? I'm always the one at the grocery store getting stuff last minute. So let me know your favorite Thanksgiving foods, your favorite Thanksgiving prep as well. And all this talk, I mentioned donuts, it got me thinking about a story on today's show as well that has all the facts you didn't know about Oreos. Now, I don't want to give it all away, but did you know that the Oreo is the best-selling cookie in the world? I mean, I didn't know until I learned it, but it's not surprising. It didn't surprise me. Can anyone guess when or where Oreos were first sold. Something else you might not know is that Oreos are technically vegan. Now we have a couple resident vegans at the Top 30 studio. We have Niklaus, we have Matt behind the camera. And they are big fans of Oreos, right guys? Mm-hmm. Yeah, oh yeah. It's one of those perks, right? They're dairy-free, nut-free, and kosher. So for all of your dietary restricted friends, Oreos are pretty safe bet. So Oreos were first sold in 1912. There has been over a century of Oreo eating. Many different ways to eat them have been invented. You know that. You've got the dunking, you've got the twist, lick the inside, or you just pop the whole thing in your mouth. A ton of different ways. What's your favorite way to eat an Oreo? Of course. I'm laughing at a comment. William says, meat is not murder. Oreos are murder. Thanks, William. Anne is just waving a hello to us. All right, on the topic of food, I asked you if you have started your Thanksgiving shopping. And so let's talk about Thanksgiving food. Let me know any tips you have, any turkey tips. You always call the Butterball hotline. I know that's always very popular. Well, today on Top 30, we reveal 5 ways to save on your Thanksgiving feast. And most obviously, our first tip is getting those deals early. So start your shopping today. I know. I need to take my own advice. I was just at Trader Joe's. They have a lot of great pre-made Thanksgiving things for all of you who like to whip things up in a jiffy. Another great way to save is by using your freezer inventory. So I love this. In fact, I just texted my husband earlier today. I want to eat everything in the freezer. So we need to start eating the food we actually have instead of grocery shopping constantly. So start going through your frozen foods. Sorry about that you could use, or just clear out some space for all your upcoming festive foods. So there's a couple tips, but we have a lot going on Top 30, as we always do, to help you guys out leading into this Thanksgiving holiday. So don't forget to watch Top 30 today to find out more. Kiyomi says, I always wait until the last minute. So Kiyomi, what do you mean by last minute? Do you mean like the day before, or do you mean like midnight? The night of, because I am like, it's dark outside, the kids are sleeping, and I'm finally getting to, it's pretty bad. Joseph Hazel says, ice cold milk. Oh, is that what you, with the Oreos, I'm assuming, with the Oreos. All right, quote of the daytime, you guys. Here we are on Friday Eve, and here's today's quote of the day. You have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes, you can steer yourself any direction you choose. I think you can guess who said that. Dr. Seuss. Love me some Dr. Seuss. My favorite Dr. Seuss book is Hooper Humperdink. If you haven't read it, please check it out. It's so good. Any parents out there, you'll love it. So Kiyomi's like me. She says she goes shopping at midnight. Okay, girlfriend, I'll see you there. All right, you guys, have a great day. I will see you on an all-new episode of Top 30. Make it a great one and usher yourself right into the weekend. All right. See you later.